Number one, are you ready? Are you ready? We will build a great wall along the southern border.
Yeah, the Republicans are still lying about the border.
So what's wrong with Congress then, Congressman? I mean, why can't you actually move the needle on securing the border? I understand you need a willing partner on the other side, and you haven't had that. But it's frustrating to see all of these illegals coming in and the drugs flowing in and really no movement.
The problem is the Republicans, not the Democrats. We know how the Democrats are going to vote. It's too many of my Republican colleagues are unwilling to vote to secure the border.
Maybe not this guy, but he's an outlier. And yes, it's true, some of them are beginning to see that Trump is destroying their party and their legacy. But is it enough?
Seal the border and I will shut down the invasion of millions of people that are coming through into our country.
If Republicans are on Fox telling Maria Amoloko that it's their fault.
The problem is the Republicans, not the Democrats.
I think it's safe to say the house is on fire. Their candidate for president has said it out loud. He doesn't want a solution because it ain't good for him.
Why were you against the House, against the Senate border deal?
It made it much better for the opposing side.
Again, it's right there on Fox News. And if Laura Ingraham had a soul, she would have said something like, what the F is wrong with you?
Just this week, it was reported that an illegal alien, and you just look at this, what's happening.
The bill Trump spiked was an overreach, but it dealt with issues that Trump wanted to campaign on. That's why he killed it. Although he'll lie regardless of whatever Congress does. Trump is a racist of the highest order, and his following is dangerous and ready to respond to Trump's directions.
I promise.
Stand back and stand by.
And it gets even more pathetic for Republicans as they try to blame illegals for voting for Democrats. Mike Johnson says he's introducing a bill to ban non-citizens from voting, even though it's already illegal for non-citizens to vote in a federal election, which is what Trump said happened, but never did.
We all know intuitively that a lot of illegals are voting in federal elections, but it's not been something that is easily provable. We don't have that number.
Whoa, wait, Mike. You know intuitively illegals are voting because how? Oh, they're not white. Good catch, Mikey, you pathetic little whipping boy. The border with Mexico was a problem, but not the problem you may think. While MAGA, led by Fatty Bananas and Dairy Queen, would have you think that terrorists are crossing the border every day, killing Americans like it's the beginning of deer season.
The U.S. witnessed a roughly 70% increase in encounters at the southwest border.
Their numbers and statistics are BS.
The problem is the Republicans, not the Democrats.
Republicans consistently lie with absolutely no facts about the dangers that undocumented people pose.
When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. And they're bringing those problems with us. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists.
I mean, there are terrorists in America, but they're not Jorge, they're George. And their white nationalist movement, propelled by Trump's presidency, poses a number one threat to Americans today. Mostly because they're ignorant to the facts I'm about to tell you, but also because they're racist.
You know, they say about America, they say, diversity is our strength.
How precisely is diversity our strength?
You know, they have chaos and violence in their communities.
Send the military into these black neighborhoods, make the streets safe, they'll complain about it. It doesn't matter.
We should send in the troops if necessary to restore order.
Enough with the Jim Crow stuff, who cares? Oh, and to drink out of a different water fountain.
And these monsters have latched onto the Republican Party and are moving them further and further away from what they used to be. And what are they now? They're a white supremacy movement.
White supremacy, that's the problem. This is a hoax.
The truth about immigrants is simple. They are the backbone of our labor force and America's breadbasket. California is the fifth largest economy in the world because of undocumented people. Immigrants, both undocumented and first generation, do the work that Americans won't. Long hours, brutally difficult conditions, and low pay. And as much as Republicans want to believe these jobs will be filled by a little Skippy, they won't. California and other states have tried, but that's only part of the story.
Former President Trump has indicated to senators that he does not want us to solve the problem at the border. He wants to lay the blame for the border at Biden. And the idea that someone running for president would say, please hurt the country so I can blame my opponent and help my politics is a shocking development.
The border bill that Trump and Mike Johnson conspired to kill was crafted by this guy, conservative Senator Jim Lankford, who was not happy in the least. When he learned that Trump had it spiked, he seemed shocked that Republicans would do something like this, put politics before country. For the record, if that's what he thought, he must have been in a coma the last 10 years.
The problem is the Republicans, not the Democrats.
The Senate bill that Republicans crafted, then allowed Trump to kill, had very strong provisions to curtail the flow of Mexicans and Central Americans into the United States. For one, it eliminated this thing called catch and release. So if an undocumented person was arrested, they were detained until their status was verified. It also had a provision to hold asylum seekers until their hearings were resolved. And if there were 5,000 border encounters, the border was closed. And on this point, let me illustrate the lie Trump tells.
Why were you against the House, against the Senate border deal, the bipartisan border?
Well, they allow 5,000 people.
And on this point, let me illustrate Trump's lies. Trump says the bill would allow 5,000 people a day into the U.S. Not true.
The problem is the Republicans.
So either Trump is lying or so cognitively impaired he doesn't know the difference.
Sympathize with this are sick. They're sick and they're evil and they're not going to be fixed. You're not going to make them into wonderful people one day. I didn't know you had flies in Iowa.
So while Trump lies about the 5,000 Mexicans pouring into our nation every day, Senator Lankford, on the other hand, a hard-ass conservative who wrote the bill, says it's not true. The border encounter includes migrants seeking asylum at the gates on the Mexican side, and those count as border encounters. Republicans who keep drilling this narrative about migrants are liars, and they don't care if you catch them in a lie because they know Fox won't report it. Today's Republican Party, led by this pencil dick Stephen Miller, created the lie that nations are opening up prisons and mental wards and sending those people to the U.S., which ain't happening.
But people are coming from the Congo. Last night, we had 20 people come. Welcome to our country from the Congo. Where do you live in the Congo? We live in prison. Oh, that's right. They released them from prison. I don't think they wanted to ask what they did, but they're coming in from Africa.
Trump has proven he'll lie about immigration whenever his mouth is open, and he doesn't care about the consequences. I don't know, maybe he wants Stormy to spank him again.
It's very demeaning to women, and I love women more than I love anything.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that, but the real irony regarding the border is the unwillingness of Republicans to address the positive effects immigration has had on our nation. Here's the truth and the irony. We were built by immigrants, and without immigration, our economy will fail. Sure. We need to be safe, but immigrants aren't what we should be worrying about. When the Republicans strutted out this bimbo for the State of the Union response, Pouty Fugknuckle lied her ass off, intimating that her story of sex trafficking happened here and under Biden, which wasn't true.
She had been sex trafficked by the cartels.
This event happened under Bush and not even here in the U.S. Immigrants, undocumented, and first-generation Americans commit 90% fewer crimes than Americans. They go to church twice as regularly. They get divorced at a fraction of the rate of Republicans. And with the slow disintegration of the Republican Party, my only question I have is, why would they want to come here?
Who's with me?
Hi, what's up?
On speed or something.
Time to pack it up.
This isn't their Republican Party anymore.
Am I wrong?
Yeah.
Tick-tock.
You're in a lot of trouble, Donnie.
Thank you so much for watching. You know, YouTube frequently penalizes my videos for taking on controversial subjects, hurting our ability to earn ad revenue, which we use to hire more hosts and make more videos. We think it's so important to make these videos now and expose a Republican cult. So please join us on Patreon. The link is in the comments. We literally can't make these without you. Thank you so much. For Real American Media,
all of a sudden, this guy is like amped.
I think he's crazy.
I'm Chip Franklin.